Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. My name's Wyatt, and today I'll be teaching you how to script a currency system on Roblox. Okay, so before I show you how to make this script, I just want to show you how it works. So, if we go into the game, as you'll see, in the top right corner in our leaderboard, we have a coin's value. And right now it's at 14 because I was doing a little bit of testing ahead of time. But if we click this part right here, it'll increment the coins by 1 each time. We wait a few seconds, leave the game. And if we come right back in, you'll see, because we're using data stores, it'll save our coins. Okay, so now that you know what this script does, I want to show you how to make it. So the first thing that we're going to do is actually create the currency handler. And this will be what saves the coins, what loads them, all that stuff. It's going to be done in the currency handler. So we'll create a new script under service, script service. And let's just name it currency handler. Now, the first line of this script is actually going to be getting the data store service, because what the data store service does is it allows us to save and load data from the data store. So if the player leaves the game and we want to save some kind of value under their user ID, we use the data store service to do it. So we'll say local data store service equals game colon get service data store service. And now we also, inside of the data store service, you can have your different types of data stores. So maybe I'm making a game that has points, and it has coins, and it has all these different things that I need to save. What I can do is I can use different data stores to actually save them. So in this case, we're going to be using a currency store. So I'm going to say local currency store equals data store service colon get data store currency store. And right here, this is just the name of the data store that we're getting. So maybe if you were saving points, or if you were saving kills or money or anything like that, you could just change the name to whatever you want. Finally, up top, what we're going to have is we need to get a reference to the players folder, because we need to get whenever a player joins. So to do that, we're just going to say local players equals game colon get service players. And that's all for the top. Now we can actually get when a player is added. So we'll hook into the player added event by saying players.playerAdded, and we'll connect that to a function. And then we'll grab the parameter of player so we can actually get the player that's been added. So for this script, we're gonna use the user ID to save the player's data and not their name. And the reason that I'm doing this is because whenever you save it with their name, if the player changes their name on Roblox, then they lose all of their data. But the user ID doesn't change when you save their name, or when they change their name. So it's a lot easier to do with user ID, and it prevents a lot of, you know, future complications. So we'll say local user ID equals player.user ID. So now what we're going to do is we're actually going to get the save value in the currency store, however much they had when they last left the game. We'll just say local currency equals currency store colon get async user ID. So whatever the value is for the user ID when they last joined the game, that's what we're going to get right here. Now the only issue, so the next few lines of code, these are really important, because if the player doesn't join the game yet and this is the first time joining the game, the value of currency is actually equal to nil, and it's not equal to a number. So what we need to do is we need to check if it's the first time and set it to a number so that everything else works right. So the way we'll do that is we'll say if currency is equal to nil, then we'll set currency to 0 because it needs to be a number, not nil. And then we'll just set async, so we'll set it in the data store. Currency store colon set async user ID, and then we will set however much currency they have, which in this case is 0. Now what we actually need to do is create the leader stats folder under the player. And I don't know if you know what leader stats is, but I can explain it real quick. So what leader stats is, it's the leaderboard on the top right of your screen. And we can put any value that we want into there. So we can put coins, points, kills, any value that we want to be shown on that top right leaderboard, we put it into a folder under the player called leader stats. So let's just pretend lighting is our player. This is the player object. If we create a new folder under there and we name it leader stats, and again, we're just pretending this is the player, capital or lowercase l, if the player, right, so if this folder is named leader stats, anything, any value underneath this folder will be shown right here with the name of the value and actual value of it. So for example, we have the leader stats folder. In this case, we're making a coin script. So what we do is if we create an int value because we want a number, and then we name that value to coins, if the player went into the game, it would say coins up top next to the player's name, and then it would say whatever value this is. So if this value is 21, it would say the player's name, and then it would say coins up top, and then it would say 21 right here, because that's the value of it. Now we're just going to do what I did right there, right, pretending it's the player. I'm going to do that through code. So the first thing we have to do for that is say local leader stats equals instance.new folder, and we're just going to parent that to the player object so that, you know, it has to be under the player. And right now it's just named folder when we create it by default. So let's name that to leader stats. So leader stats.name equals leader stats. Next, after this, we'll create a new coins value. Just like we were doing here, we create coins. So coins equals instance.new int value. And we'll parent that to leader stats, so it'll be just like this setup. And then we'll just name it coins so that the player knows it's coins, it's not just value, because, you know, they wouldn't know what it was, so we have to set it the name to coins. Just like this, equals coins. And then, so now we only have a little bit left. We have a few more lines, about four more lines of code. And what we have to do is now we have to save the coins whenever they're changed, and we actually have to set it at first. So right now the currency is equal to 0 if you haven't joined, but it's equal to 20 or something else if you've already, you know, clicked the button, you've gained currency by playing the game. And we want to show that to the player. So the way we do that is just by saying coins.value equals currency, and that just does the same as changing the value right here, as I explained earlier. So now what we actually have to do, we're almost done, we have to set the value in the data store whenever it's changed. So let's say I have 20 coins and I gain a coin, so I have 21 coins now. Well, just because I changed it over here in the leader stats doesn't mean that it gets saved to the data store. So if the player left and rejoined, it wouldn't show their updated coins. So what we have to do is we actually have to hook into the event that gets fired whenever the value is changed. So we'll just say coins.changed, that's the event, and then we'll connect that to a function, and we'll grab the new value. So whatever the old value was, we don't want that, we want the new value. So let's say the old value is 20, and then the player's coins gets changed to 21. That new value variable, that'll be equal to 21. And then after that, it's just one line. All we do is we say currency store, and we set async. The key is the user ID, and then the value is new value. So it'll save it to the data store whenever this value or coins value underneath the player is changed. Now, this is pretty cool, but right now we have no way to actually give the player any coins. So I'm going to show you how we do that. We're actually going to hook it up to a click detector, but you can run this code however you want. You know, I mean, it doesn't matter. It's just, I'm just going to do it in a click detector for demonstration purposes. So we'll create a new part under workspace, and let's just make it green, make it all fancy, and we can name it coins part, and then we'll create a new script under here, and we will name it give coins script, and we need a click detector as well, just so that we can actually handle the player click on the part. And this is very simple. All we have to do is say script.parent.clickDetector.mouseClick, and then we want to connect that to a function. And in that function, we want to get the player who clicked, because we need to know who we're incrementing the coins for. And then all we have to say is local coins equals player who clicked dot leader stats dot coins. And this will get the current coins value, the current amount that they have. And then we just want to increment that by one. So coins dot value, because we have to get the value property of the int value, equals coins dot value plus one. And as I said before, right, whenever we change this, because we have this, right, whenever this line of code runs, these lines of code right here also run because the coins get changed. So if we go into the game, we can test this out, and you'll see all we have to do is walk right on over to the green part, and if we click on it, you see our coins keeps going up. So 6, 7, 8. And you see, it's a lot of requests right now because I'm doing it really quick, but, you know, in your game, you'll be giving coins slower. But it saved the coins, and we can actually prove that by heading out and coming right back in. The value gets created underneath our player, and we have 8 coins. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you learned something new today about scripting on Roblox. As always, I'll have the pasted-in link with the code and the Roblox model link for everything shown in this video in the description, and I'll see you later.